What is the holiest time of the year? The shortest and the holiest time of the year. The celebrations of the Holy Week are so important that we spend 40 days preparing for them with fasting, prayer, and almsgiving. Lent is a time of preparation to allow us to fully enter into the most important time of the year, the sacred Triduum. The holiest time of the year, it is called the sacred Triduum from Holy Thursday until the Easter Vigil. It is meant to be kind of three-day retreat for the whole church where we meditate on the profound outpouring of love that comes through the mysteries of Christ. It's where we allow ourselves to live this 3 day again with Christ, to experience anew the depth of love contained in each of these mysteries. And the 3 day, or the Triduum, the sacred Triduum, begins with Holy Thursday. It begins with Holy Thursday, always celebrated in the evening, where we commemorate the Last Supper of Jesus with the Apostles when He gave us the incredible gift of the Eucharist, as well as the priesthood that makes it possible. The washing of the feet reminds us how the Eucharist calls us to pour out our lives in the service, and how Christ humbled Himself to become one of us in order to wash away our sins. It ends with the solemn procession of the Blessed Sacrament to the altar of repose, where we are invited to keep watch silently with Christ, even into the night. Just as He requested His apostles to stay awake and pray with Him in the Garden of Gethsemane. You will notice that the liturgy does not have a formal dismissal, but simply ends with all of us praying silently before the altar of repose. Our retreat has begun, and we are invited to make these 3 days different from the rest of the year, even keeping a more prayerful silence in our homes, as the whole church also fasts in preparation for the Easter feast. The second day is the Good Friday. The second day of the sacred Triduum is the Good Friday. We gather again on Good Friday, which also begins in silence with the prostration of the priest before the stripped altar and sanctuary. Notice there is no introduction and greeting, but simply the invocation, "Let us pray," since in a certain way we are only continuing what we began the night before. This liturgy includes the reading of the entire Passion from John's Gospel, often chanted with different parts. It also has the veneration of the cross. I still remember as a child how much of an impression it made on me to go up and kiss the cross. Indeed, this is allowed us by the universal petitions often prayed while kneeling for each one of us. On this most solemn day, when Christ gave His life for us, we beg Him for grace for ourselves and for the whole world. We end this celebration by receiving Holy Communion, but it is the only day of the church year where there is no celebration of Holy Mass. Again, the liturgy ends with a blessing but no dismissal. The rubric says, "All depart in silence," and we continue our retreat. This would be a great opportunity to continue prayer at home as a family, as we keep a somber attitude in remembering Christ's death. And finally, the last day of the sacred Triduum is the Holy Saturday. The three-day retreat culminates with the celebration of the Lord's victory over death in the Easter Vigil. The rubrics remind us that this Mother of all Vigils is the greatest and most noblest of all solemnities, and it is to be unique in every single church. The Roman Missal states, "On this holy night, the church stays up into the night, keeping watch, celebrating the resurrection of Christ in the sacraments and awaiting His return in glory. After all, we know that Christ will return in glory some night, and it makes sense it might happen on the anniversary of His resurrection." The vigil is not allowed to begin before nightfall, 8 p.m. this year, so that the lighting of the holy fire for the Easter candle reveals the light of Christ's resurrection, dispelling the darkness of our world. The light is fresh to each of us, and we stand in the dark with our lighted candles and sing the exalted. In this profound text, we proclaim the salvation won for us in Christ's resurrection. Our all love, O charity, beyond all telling, to ransom a slave you gave away your son. O truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ, O happy fault that earned so great, so glorious a redeemer. At this, we have up to seven readings that recount the whole history of salvation from creation until now. How important it is to spend this time once a year remembering what God has done for us. I suggest that we spend time during these days meditating on the profound readings, which can be found in the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops website. These readings end with a great Alleluia, which we have not said for all Lent, and the proclamation of the Gospel with the homily. Then we had the Easter sacraments. Through the baptisms, confirmation, and First Communion, we see the gift of eternal life, which Christ won for us, implanted in the hearts of our new brothers and sisters for the first time. These new Catholics join us now in sharing the gift of eternal life through Christ's death and resurrection. Then we celebrate in full glory the liturgy of the Eucharist, from which we have fasted since Thursday evening. Part of this beauty of Easter is that the solemn celebration lasts 8 days until the following Sunday, and then continues for 50 days of rejoicing. These 3 days of the Triduum provide an incredible gift for us to enter more deeply into the love of Christ. I hope and pray that you will be able to make or to take full advantage of this annual retreat that the Church offers us. Through the celebration of these mysteries, we experience more deeply how much Christ loves us and how much salvation means for us. And we have the chance to grow more into living His life and love every day. Don't miss the Easter Triduum. As I said a while ago, that what is the most holiest day of the year? It is called the Easter Triduum, or the Sacred Triduum, from Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and Holy Saturday. Easter Vigil. God bless. Once again, don't forget to subscribe on my YouTube channel so that you will be updated for more Alam mo ba, or do you know that? God bless.